Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
You're watching South Asia Newsline, and here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Thursday, the 2nd of May. New India kills enemies inside their homes. PM Modi slams Congress dossier approach. Maldivian Foreign Minister to visit India next week in a first major bilateral visit. And thousands of people rally in Colombo on May Day. And now for all the details. Launching a scathing attack on opposition Congress Party, Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Thursday said, during their regime, they used to send dossiers on terrorists, but his government seeks to kill them on their home turfs. Speaking during a rally in Gujarat's Anand, PM Modi said, today India does not send dossiers to the terrorists, but gives them a dose. Furthermore, Modi said during their 70-year rule, Congress could not implement the constitution in the entire country, and it is only his party who is committed to the constitution.
आतंक के आकाओं को डोजियर देती थी। डोजियर का मतलब है फाइल पे सारी जानकारियां इकट्ठी कर करके वो देते थे कि तुम्हारे लोग आए थे, ये उनकी फोटो है, यहां बम फोड़ के चले गए। तुम्हारे लोग आए थे, इतने लोगों को मार करके चले गए। तुम्हारे वो लोग आए थे, डोजियर देते थे, डोजियर। और फिर देश को बताते थे, हमने पाकिस्तान को डोजियर दे दिया है। डोजियर। और मोदी की मजबूत सरकार देखिए, डोजियर बोजियर में टाइम खराब नहीं करते। आतंकियों को घर में घुसकर मारते हैं।
However, over the controversy of Congress manifesto, the party's president Mallikarjun Kharge wrote a letter to PM Modi challenging him and BJP leaders to have a debate over it. PM Modi in his election campaigns has repeatedly criticized the manifesto, saying that the Congress party has dangerous intentions of distributing the money of the poor to the Muslim community. However, Kharge said that the manifesto only speaks of justice and speaks of bringing growth for all sections of the society. PM Modi is seeking a record equaling third straight term on the back of his economic record, welfare measures, national pride, Hindu nationalism and personal popularity. Surveys suggest he will easily win a comfortable majority. The seven-phase general election began on April 19th and the results will be out on 4th of June. And in a relentless effort to track down terrorists who have taken refuge in the Dudu Basangar forests, the search operation by security forces entered fifth consecutive day in India's Jammu and Kashmir territory. Security forces have deployed unmanned aerial vehicles to track down the terrorists and have expanded the search radius to Kathua district, which has a cover of thick vegetation. The search operation began this past weekend based on intelligence inputs about the presence of terrorists in the region who fled to the forest area after killing a village defense guard member in Udhampur district. Meanwhile, troops of border security forces foiled an infiltration attempt at the international border in Samba in the wee hours of Thursday. In a statement, the BSF said troops stationed at the border post observed suspicious movement across the border area. Challenged multiple times by the troops but continuing to advance, the intruder was neutralized by the force. A top BSF official said that the slain intruder is believed to be a scout who was trying to sneak into the Indian territory to facilitate further infiltration of terrorists from Pakistan.
लेकिन शायद मुझे लगता है कि ये सिर्फ प्रोब करने के लिए ही इसको शायद आगे भेजा गया था गाइड टाइप कि अगर मौका मिलता है तो फिर बाकियों का भी किया जाए हालांकि ट्रूप्स में पीछे और कोई ऐसा मूवमेंट देखा नहीं, बट इस तरह के काम लगभग जो अंदाजा हम लगाते हैं इसी टाइप के होते हैं।
मूविंग ऑन, मालदीव्स फॉरेन मिनिस्टर मूसा जमीर इज सेट टू विजिट इंडिया नेक्स्ट वीक, 6 months after the win of the pro-China leader Mohammad Muizu for the first bilateral visit since the change in the leadership. The visit is not only going to take place 6 months into Muizu's administration, but also amid 6-week-long general elections in India. It holds significance due to the ongoing tensions between the two countries. Muizu's election campaign had been based on the India Out platform, which demanded that the withdrawal of all Indian troops based in the Maldives, accusing former President Ibrahim Soleh of compromising sovereignty. Eyebrows were also raised in India when Muizu had chosen to travel to China in the first week of January. It was probably the first time in recent decades that a Maldivian president had gone to China before traveling to India. In a dig at Pakistan Prime Minister Shehbaz Sharif's government, the ruling coalition's former ally, JUIF chief Maulana Fazlur Rahman, on Wednesday termed the PMLN-led government as helpless and said it was useless to complain to the Prime Minister as he did not enjoy real powers. The opposition leader, addressing an event in support of Palestine, said we should talk to those who wield real power. He said it was time for the Prime Minister to spell out his stance on major issues concerning the country and to reveal its plan. Notably, Fazlur Rahman-led JUIF was a major part of the Pakistan Democratic Movement government that came to power after ousting jailed former PM Imran Khan from office through a no-confidence vote. However, in the past few weeks, he has been vocal against the PMLN and PPP coalition government and has alleged that the extensive rigging happened during the general elections. Moving on. Residents in Pakistan-occupied Kashmir have expressed dismay over soaring inflation and have accused the government of being apathetic towards their plight by failing to regulate prices.
Locals in Pakistan-occupied Kashmir have raised concern over frequent hike in prices of fuel, gas and other commodities that have severely hit domestic budgets. Pakistan has been witnessing economic challenges owing to its incompetent policies. However, this occupied region, which is already marginalized, has borne the major brunt of unfair taxes and high inflation.
सैकड़ों खानदानों को, दर्जनों सैकड़ों खानदानों को अपने आका के मुताबिक जानता हूँ, जो अब 3 वक्त के बजाय 2 वक्त का खाना खाते हैं और वो उनके खाने की मियार में कमी आ गई बजाय इस्तेकाम के, वो उसी तरह अचानक पता चलता है जी आज वो के रेट बढ़ गए। इसलिए हुकूमत को तवील मुद्दत की पॉलिसी बनानी चाहिए।
Altaf Bhatt further said, Pakistan has also failed to address wheat and gas crisis in the region, and he made comparison with India's efforts to provide amenities to its citizens.
Thousands of people in Sri Lanka on Wednesday took to the streets of Colombo City to participate in May Day rallies organized by different political parties. This year's rallies were held as presidential elections are expected in mid-October. President Ranil Wickremesinghe, in his address, told supporters and all opposition to join him in developing the country facing the worst economic crisis since independence in 1948.
මම අනික් පක්ෂවලට කියනවා සමගි බලවේගයට ජනතා විමුක්ති පෙරමුණට මේකට විරුද්ධව යන්න එපා මේවා කඩන්න යන්න එපා ජනතාව ගැන හිතලා මේ තත්ත්වය ආරක්ෂා කරන්නට ආණ්ඩුව එක්ක ගිවිසුමකට එන්න කියලා මං ඉල්ලලා සිටිනවා රට ගැන හිතන්න.
Meanwhile, the main opposition, United People's Power Party, and the left-wing National People's Power Party drew large crowds as well. According to authorities, thousands of police were deployed to provide security and a special traffic plan was underway.
රටේම ලක්ෂ 220ට මම කියන්න කැමති ඔබ අපිව විශ්වාස කරනවා නම් ඔබ අපිව පිළිගන්නවා නම් ඔබ අපි අවංකයයි සිතනවා නම් අපේ පොරොන්දු පත්‍රයට එකතු වෙන්න අපේ පොරොන්දු පත්‍රයත් සමග අත්වැල් බැඳ ගන්න අවිශ්වාස කරන ඕනම කෙනෙකුට විකල්පයක් දිහා බලන්නට පුළුවන්
And as Bangladesh endures its longest heat wave on record, sales of air conditioners have skyrocketed across the country. The heat wave situation has forced closure of schools, while residents have been advised to mostly stay indoors.
Sales of air conditioners have skyrocketed in Bangladesh, shop owners and customers have said, as the South Asian nation endures one of its longest heat wave on record. A store owner in Dhaka's bustling stadium market said, while the demand has significantly increased, supply from manufacturers has not kept up, leading to a surge in prices. Earlier this week, temperatures reached 43 degrees Celsius as the ongoing heat wave continues to force the government to waver between opening and closing schools for some 33 million students.
কোম্পানি মাল দেন এসি কোম্পানির দাম অনেক বাড়াই দিছে জেসি 15 দিন আগে ছিল 66000 টাকা সেই হচ্ছে এখন কোম্পানি রিকোয়েস্ট করে 72000 টাকা তো আমরা এই লোক কাস্টমার সবাই একসাথে বাজারে নেইমা যায় চাহিদা বাইরে যায় চাইজন যে কোম্পানি মাল দিতে পারে না এর কারণে দাম বাইরে আছে এই হচ্ছে এসি পরিস্থিতি তারপরে সব মডেল अवेलेबल পাওয়া যায় না
Meanwhile residents in parts of India beat the heat by covering themselves up as they ventured out and sipped on juice buttermilk and other drinks to keep themselves cool and hydrated. India's weather office has forecast more heat wave days than normal between April and June this year.
गर्मी है गर्मी में लस्सी पी रहे हैं थोड़ा सा आनंद रहेगा देख रहे हैं कितनी गर्मी जो जून जुलाई वाली गर्मी अभी पड़ने लग गई है
That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.